was just, you know, just chit-chatting about life. He mentioned something about the Ruff Ryders. Like, oh yeah, the Ruff Ryders, the guys that are being those rap videos like DMX and Queen Latifah. He goes, yeah, well, you know, I'm a member. I'm like, what? When were you ever gonna tell me he was a member of the Ruff Ryders? Yo, what's up, my YouTube fam? I remember the day when I met the Ruff Ryders. It was a cool experience. Now, a few years ago, me and my brother-in-law was sitting around talking, watching the game, and we was just, you know, just chit-chatting about life. He mentioned something about the Ruff Ryders. Like, oh yeah, the Ruff Ryders, the guys that are being those rap videos like DMX and Queen Latifah. He goes, yeah, well, you know, I'm a member. I'm like, what? When were you ever going to tell me he was a member of the Ruff Ryders? Had no clue. Now, there's different stages in becoming a Ruff Ryder. In order to get that leather jacket with the embroidery on there that has the logo, you got to put in some serious long hours and accomplishes a lot of tasks. Well, he was almost at the finish line. He wasn't quite a full member yet, but he had access to the organization and the people and things like that. And we were talking, and he said, yeah, because he was making flyers for an upcoming car wash for two members of the organization had fallen. They unfortunately lost their life in motorcycle accidents. So they're going to have like a donation car wash, raise money for the families of the fallen. And we were talking, and I said, man, how can I contribute, and blah, blah, blah. He said, well, you want to meet the lead chapter guy? I'm like, yeah. You know, here's my information. Tell him what I do. And, well, my brother-in-law, Jack, had contacted him and told him about me and what I do, that I'm an author. He went nuts. Wait a minute. You mean to tell me your brother-in-law is a black author right here in town? And that's how the conversation went. It was cool. Make a long story short, we combined everything together. I had an up-and-coming book signing for the release of my brand new book, Electro Blacknetic. It's a book of poetry, prose, short stories, and also true stories of incidents with cops in California. So what we did, we combined a car wash, the book signing, did everything outdoors for the community and the neighborhood, and it was cool. Now the day came for the actual event to take place. We got there early, we hired a photographer. It was gonna be incredible. We had a barbecue, we had a DJ out there, we had the car wash set up. We rented out this big old lot. It was cool, right? And I didn't realize how big the Ruff Ryders were. So when they showed up, the local Sacramento chapter showed up first, because obviously they're in town. I had no idea they had members coming from the Bay Area, Fresno, damn near from LA, all coming at the same time. And when you hear all that thundering roar of the engines of the motorcycles coming down the street, and literally you see over 10 to 20 cyclists at one time coming down the street on motorcycles, your heart is pounding, man. It was a trip. They all pulled in at the same time, blasting their loud music. It's something you would see in a movie. And man, it was cool. We all got a chance to chat, meet each other, and hang out. And doing something together, combined like that, has never been done before between an organization like Blacktastic and Ruff Ryders. And to have an author hook up with some bikers, you know, it seemed so unconventional, but it felt so right. And it was received well. We raised a bunch of money at the car wash to give to the families of the fallen. Man, I must have moved over 35 to 40 books that day. Man, you talk about a great day. It was cool. And to make everything better, man, we took a whole bunch of pictures. And now I have communication on a regular basis with the Ruff Ryders. They're just a phone call away. So we plan on doing more events like that in the future, where we, you know, wear awareness for like cancer, autism, and things like that. So as a matter of fact, at the end of this video, stay tuned. I have a montage of pictures of the event. Until then, next time on True Stories.